Theresa May has passed her biggest hurdle yet on the road to Brexit, as the European Commission cleared the way for negotiations on the future relationship after the UK's withdrawal from the EU. Britain will pay a divorce bill of up to £39 billion under the terms of a withdrawal package agreed with Brussels. The breakthrough was hailed by the Prime Minister as a hardwon agreement in all our interests, Commission President JeanClaude Juncker said it represented sufficient progress for negotiations to move on to their second phase, subject to approval by leaders of the remaining 27 EU states at a summit on December 14-15. In dramatic pre-dawn scenes, Mrs. May and Brexit Secretary David Davis flew to Brussels to confirm with Mr. Juncker over breakfast the text of a joint document setting out proposals on the key withdrawal issues of citizens' rights, the Irish border and Britain's exit bill. But the scene was set for further wrangling, as European Council President Donald Tusk set out guidelines for the next phase of talks, covering the transition to a post-Brexit relationship, which envisaged the UK staying in the single market and customs union and observing all EU laws for around 2 years after the official withdrawal date in March 2019. He said only exploratory talks on a free trade agreement could begin at this stage, with the EU's chief Brexit negotiator Michel Barnier suggesting that real negotiations on trade would get underway once a withdrawal treaty is finalised in October. Brexit EU CEO read joint report from the negotiators of the European Union and the United Kingdom government on progress during phase 1 of negotiations under Article 50 TEU on the United Kingdom's orderly withdrawal from the European Union https://t.cormacril5x?amp1 European Commission at EU_Commission December 8, 2017 Mr. Barnier also threw cold water on Mrs. May's hopes for a deepened special trading relationship with the EU. He warned that her red lines of taking the UK out of the single market, the customs union and the jurisdiction of the European Court of Justice left a free trade deal similar to Canada's as the only option open to Britain. There was consternation among some Brexit backers over provisions allowing the European Court of Justice a role in overseeing EU citizens' rights in the UK for 8 years after Brexit. However, Downing Street said they only expected around 2 or 3 cases a year to be referred voluntarily by UK judges to the Luxembourg Court. I've sent Brexit guidelines for second phase to EU27 leaders. While being satisfied with today's agreement, let's remember that the most difficult challenge still ahead. Breaking up is hard. But breaking up and building a new relationship is much harder. https://t.code6isk11h Donald Tusk at UK President December 8, 2017 Citizens can now be confident about the rights they enjoy. We should now move forward to discuss our future relationship with the EU on issues like trade and security. David Davis at David Davis December 8, 2017 and a compromise on the Irish border, forged in intensive talks late on Thursday night after the Democratic Unionist Party blocked an earlier deal on Monday, states that if no trade deal is reached, the UK as a whole will maintain alignment with elements of the EU single market and customs union which support the economy of the island of Ireland in the Good Friday Agreement. Tory former Brexit minister David Jones warned this could severely handicap Britain's ability to enter free trade agreements covering areas like agriculture with countries outside the EU, like the US, but Foreign Secretary Boris Johnson insisted the PM was determined to ensure the measures' compatibility with taking back control of our money, laws, and borders. Mr. Johnson and fellow cabinet Brexiteer Michael Gove gave their public blessing to the deal, with the Environment Secretary describing it as a significant personal political achievement for the Prime Minister, which would make more money available for the NHS. Congratulations to PM for her determination in getting today's deal. We now aim to forge a deep and special partnership with our European friends and allies while remaining true to the referendum result, taking back control of our laws, money and borders for the whole of the UK, Boris Johnson at Boris Johnson December 8, 2017 The development was also welcomed by business leaders, who had warned that companies would begin activating plans to move staff and activities abroad if no progress was made by Christmas. The pound rose on the announcement. In a Brussels press conference, Mrs. May said the process of arriving at a withdrawal deal hasn't been easy for either side, but the agreement represented significant improvement on the text she was preparing to sign off on Monday. Provisions on citizens' rights would allow EU nationals in the UK to go on living their lives as before. Meanwhile, the financial settlement would be fair to the British taxpayer, and the agreement on Ireland would guarantee there would be no hard border between Northern Ireland and the Republic. PA graphic. I very much welcome the prospect of moving ahead to the next phase, to talk about trade and security and to discuss the positive and ambitious future relationship that is in all of our interests, said Mrs. May. Mr. Juncker said Brexit was a sad development, but added, now we must start looking to the future, a future in which the UK will remain a close friend and ally. Friday's announcement came after late-night telephone conversations with DUP leader Arlene Foster, as the Prime Minister sought a formula which would resolve the party's concerns about Northern Ireland being treated differently from the rest of the UK. As No. 10's staff Christmas party took place elsewhere in the building, Mrs. May finalised a text shortly before midnight. I very much welcome the prospect of moving ahead to the next phase of the Brexit talks on trade and security, and to discuss the positive and ambitious future relationship that is in all of our interests. https://t.cokies4sgvn8pic.twitter.com/zaxa8teresa May at Theresa underscore May December 8, 2017 it specified that no new regulatory barriers will be allowed between Northern Ireland and the rest of the UK, and that the province's businesses will continue to have unfettered access to the UK internal market. Mrs. Foster said, substantial changes to the text ensured there was no red line down the Irish Sea, and no special status for Northern Ireland, but added that there was still further work to be done. Irish Premier Leo Varadkar, who held telephone talks with Mrs. May on Thursday as the details of the deal were hammered out, said it was a significant day for Ireland, which achieved all that we set out to achieve in phase one of these negotiations. Mrs. May said the deal included a financial settlement which was fair to the British taxpayer. Etienne Ansoudioupatha estimated Brexit bill, significantly lower than the £50 billion or more suggested by previous leaks, covers Britain's share of the EU's budget up to the end of 2020, as well as outstanding debts and liabilities for items such as the pensions of staff at European institutions. It will be paid over several years and the exact figure is unlikely to be known for some time. The financial settlement will be drawn up and paid in euro. Jeremy Corbyn said Mrs. May had only managed to scrape through the first phase of Brexit negotiations some 18 months after the referendum. Tory chaos and posturing has caused damaging delay and risked serious harm to our economy, said the Labour leader. We need a much stronger and more constructive approach in crucial phase two. A deal in Brussels is good news for Mrs. May as we can now move on to the next stage of humiliation. Nigel Farage at Nigel Farage December 8, 2017 Mr. Tusk warned that the most difficult challenge is still ahead. We all know that breaking up is hard, but breaking up and building a new relation is much harder, said the European Council President. Since the Brexit referendum, a year and a half has passed, so much time has been devoted to the easier part of the task, and now to negotiate the transition agreement and the framework for our future relationship we have de facto less than a year.